Hello friends, this is Mahesh Pathak and welcome to Pathak's Microbiology Academy. In this video lecture, we are going to discuss about biological classification and taxonomical categories of this biological classification. Okay, so let's start the lecture. Let me start the presentation first. Okay, so we are having this presentation. Please wait a minute. Okay, let's put it here. Okay, everything is set. So in this video lecture, friends, we are going to discuss about diversity in the living world, as we have discussed it earlier in the lecture number 3 of this chapter. But let's revise it again, and then we will move to the next topic, which is biological classification. Okay, so let's start. Let's revise it in a second. Okay, so this is diversity in the living world. So what is biodiversity? As we discussed in the last lecture, the diverse from the organism present on the earth is called biodiversity. So many organisms, as we have seen, 1.7 to 1.8 million species are present on this earth. So this vast diversity and variety of organism is known as biodiversity. So in last lecture, we have studied biodiversity as well as in the binomial nomenclature as given by Carlos Linnaeus. So what is nomenclature? It is the systemic naming of the organism. So every organism have its particular kind of name. So there are two types of name which we have studied. One is vernacular name and second is scientific name. Okay, what is vernacular or common name? Vernacular name is used in a local area, and scientific names are universal, which are used all over the world. A single name will be used all over the world to point out certain type of species. Okay, so this is nomenclature. Then plants and animals are known in the local area by their local names or vernacular name. Local name, vernacular name, one and the same thing. These local names are vary from place to place, region to region, and within country. These local names are vary. Like in Maharashtra, there will be another name for mango, and in Rajasthan, it will be some other names. So the names will be vary from place to place, these local names. But scientific names are universal for and same for all over the world. So this is the difference between vernacular name and scientific name. So after that, one thing I forgot to mention last lecture is identification. Identification is also necessary. Identification is a process of assigning a pre-existing taxon name to an individual organism. So what is identification, guys? Let's assume that we found some new species. So that species will be compared to the pre-existing ones, and their characters will be compared and studied. So, and according to their characters, that new species will be named. So that process is called as identification. So identification is a process of assigning a pre-existing taxon name to an individual organism. So these are two organizations which are used to give such names, like International Code for Botanical Nomenclature, ICBN, and which used to give names for plants. Okay, so this organization will be used for naming of plants, and International Code for Zoological Nomenclature, ICZN, is used for animals. Okay, so these are two important organizations which are mainly used, which gives names to certain plants and animals. So please remember this. After that, we have discussed about Carlos Linear, who gives us this very important nomenclature system, which is binomial nomenclature, in which the first name is the first name is of genus and second name is of species. So binomial means there will be two names. One, the first will be of genus and second will be of species. So this system was given by Carlos Linnaeus. There are some rules for these nomenclature. Okay, the scientific naming system or binomial nomenclature system having some rules as to how we can use these names. So this is the first. Biological names are used in usually written in Latin word and in italics form. As if we are writing certain type of a biological name, so it will be written in Latin. Latin means, let's say we will write like this, Mangifera indica. Okay, so in Latin word or in italics in font. Okay, so this is scientific name and this will be written in Latin or and in italic font. Okay, so whenever the biological name will be written, it will be written in italic font. So this is very important rule. Then a scientific name usually contains two parts. First word is of genus, as we have discussed. Second word is of species. So always remember this. First one is of genus and second one is of species. Genus name starts with the capital letter while species name starts with the small letter. Okay, so this is genus Mangifera indica, and this the species name will be of small letters. It will be start from small letter. Then biological name is printed in italics to indicate their Latin origin and underlined when it is handwritten. So whenever we are writing by hands, so it will be underlined, or if we are printing, it will be printed in italics. So these names will be printed in italics, or they will be printed in, so if we are writing, they will be underlined. Okay, so these are some rules. Like here are some examples how we can write Mangifera indica for mango, Homo sapiens for humans, or Oryza sativa. These are the scientific names, and this is common name. Okay, so Triticum astivum for wheat. So these are some scientific names, are the examples for the binomial nomenclature system. So these are some rules. After that, in this lecture, we are going to discuss about classification. So why do we require this classification, guys? Let's understand this phenomena first. Why do we require classification? Because as we have seen that, there are millions of species are found and known on this earth. Okay, so to study such a vast number of species, we must classify them in certain groups to study them properly. Okay, because if we don't classify them and study in each and individual one, it cannot be possible. So for study purpose and for our convenience, we do classify them in certain groups, and that process is known as classification. As we go to the libraries, and there are so many thousands of books are present in the library. So these books are basically classified in certain groups, so that whenever we want to read certain type of book, we will go to the particular type of shelf and take that book, and after that we will read that book. Okay, so this is the process. To make this process convenient, we do classify the books in a libraries. So similar to that, organisms or species on this earth are also classified in certain groups. So that process is very important, and that process is known as classification. So what is classification? It is a process of grouping organisms into categories based on easily observable characters. Okay, so this process is known as classification. After that, what is taxon? The scientific term for any unit used in the science for biological classification is called taxon. Okay, the scientific term for any unit. So there are certain units and categories, and that unit, one unit will be known as there are certain units in the process of classification, and that unit, particular unit, will be known as taxon. What is taxonomy? Taxonomy is a science defining groups of a biological organism on the basis of shared characteristics and giving names to those groups. So that study or that science, we can call it as taxonomy. So Carlos Linnaeus is regarded as the father of taxonomy, as he introduced the binomial nomenclature and classification. That's why we consider Carlos Linnaeus as father of taxonomy. So basically, I think it's enough for this slide. Process of taxonomy having characterization, identification, classification, and nomenclature. These are the four steps. Let's move to the next slide. After that, systematics. The word systematic is derived from Latin. What is systematics? The word systematic is derived from Latin word systema, means systematic arrangement of organisms. So we are having systematic arrangement of such organisms for study purpose, and that process, and the systematic is the study of diversification of living forms, both past and present, and the relationships among living things through time. So what is the relationship between two groups? So that will be studied in the process or the study of systematics. So that is known as systematics. After that, Linnaeus used the Systema Nature as the title of his publication. It's not so necessary for you. Let's move to the next slide. After that, taxonomic categories. So what is taxonomic categories? This is very important in the process of classification. Okay. So what is taxonomic categories? Classification involves a hierarchy of steps where each step represents a rank or category. So taxonomic category, or we are having certain steps, and that particular or one step is known as taxonomical category. So as we will see what is taxonomic category. So these are some taxonomic categories of biological classification. So let's move from bottom to top. So this is species, genus, family, order, class, phylum, and kingdom. So these are some taxonomical categories. We will discuss one by one as this slide is showing us. Okay, so this is species. Let's learn what is mean by species. So what is species? Species is a group of individuals in which the individuals can interbreed among themselves. These are the groups of individuals in which the two individuals will be interbreed to each other. Okay, so that group will be known as species. So here we are having some examples like Mangifera indica is a species, Solanum tuberosum, potato, then Panthera leo is a, these are some species. Members of species have a large number of similar characters. So they are having large number of similar characters, but some difference will be there, but they will be considered in the same group, which that group will be known as species. Okay, so species, what is species? Species is a group of individuals in which, this word is very important, the individuals will be interbreed among themselves. Okay, so this is known as species. Then second category is genus. A group of closely related species is called as genus. So we have discussed genus, species. What is species? The individuals which can be interbred among themselves. That group is known as species. So what is genus? The group of closely related species. So there are number of and millions of species. But in them, in such vast number of spaces, there will be some spaces in which they are having so many similarity. So that similar spaces will be grouped in one genus. Okay. So group of closely related species is known as genus. So I hope this is clear. The group of closely related species is known as genus. Example, after example, it will be more clear to you, which is potato, tomato, brinjal. Okay, these are some three species. These are three different species, but all belong to the same genus Solanum. Okay, so Solanum is a genus, and in Solanum, we are having three closely related species, which is potato, tomato, and brinjal. Okay, so these are three species which are closely related and so many similarities, and these three species are grouped in one genus, which is Solanum. So Solanum is a genus. Another example is lion, leopard, and tiger. These are three species grouped in one genus called Panthera. So Panthera is a genus in which we are having three similar species, which is leopard, and tiger. Okay. I hope this is clear. The group of closely related species known as genus. Then family. What is family? A group of closely related genera or genus is known as family. Okay. So nothing complexity here. The same thing, but group of closely related genera in family. So here is example, like family Solanaceae, in which three similar genera are present or genus are present, which is Solanum, Petunia, and Datura. Okay, so these are three genus, similar genus grouped in one family known as Solanaceae. In animals, genus Panthera and genus Felis belongs to the family Felidae. So this is family. Okay, guys, what we are studying is the taxonomical categories one by one. Okay, so first we have discussed species, then genera, then family, and now we are discussing order. What is order? A group of closely related families is known as order. Simple group of closely related families is called order. Order and other higher taxonomic categories are identified based on the aggregates of characters. So they are having some certain particular types of similar characters, and by identifying those characters and studying those characters, we are grouping them in particular type of group. Okay, so these are the grouping systems in which we are studying step by step the taxonomical categories. Okay, so what is order? The group of closely related families is called order. Let's see the example. Plant families like Convolvulaceae, Solanaceae are included in order Polymoniales. Okay, in animals, Felidae and Considae belong to the order Carnivora. Then class. Class is a major category made by one or more related orders that possess certain similar characters, correlated characters. So closely related orders will be in class. Okay, in class, so many closely related orders will be present. One example is class Mammalia has a number of orders like Carnivora, Rodentia, Primata, Insectivora, etc. All possess mammary glands, external ears, and hairs. So this is class. Then phylum, which is another higher category than class. What will be in phylum? closely related classes. Okay, so closely related classes is called a file. Closely related classes will be grouped in one file. Okay, so example is that fishes, amphibia, reptilia, eels, mammalia belong to the phylum Chordata. So this is phylum and these are some classes. Okay, then the ultimate and a major category, which is kingdom. Okay, kingdom. What is kingdom? We all know that there are five major kingdoms like Animalia, plants, Plantae, Monera, in which bacteria are present, then Fungi and Protista. Okay, so this is five kingdom system which is given by R.H. Whittaker. Okay, so remember the scientist name. These are some five kingdoms in which the, what is kingdom then? The group of all related phyla or phylum is called as kingdom. So example of kingdom are these five kingdoms. Plantae comprise all plants from various divisions. So this is all about taxonomical categories. So this is the last slide. Let's look what is in it. Taxonomical studies. What is taxonomical studies? We will take another lecture for this, and we will study how taxonomical aids are used in to study the classification system. Okay, so I think it's enough for today. Thank you so much for joining, guys. We are making videos, biological lecture videos for 11th and 12th classes. If you like this video, please subscribe to the channel and share this video to your friends and contacts. Okay, so there are more videos will be there for you in this channel. Okay, thank you so much for watching.